Now I will take you back at the beginnings of textile research, because from where I came, we are actually there at the beginnings. So this presentation is a result of the project Textile Production in Prehistoric Times in the territory of Macedonia, during which artifacts for producing textile from Neolithic period until Iron Age were documented, and also documentation of preserved textile and basketry impression from Neolithic and Neolithic period was provided. As part of this project, a reconstruction of prehistoric loom was made and the weaving technique preserved on the ceramic fragments discovered in the settlements. In this presentation, I will focus on the textile impression from the Neolithic settlements. The analysis based on 39 impressions on bottom fragments on ceramic vessels and one leg of an altar from six settlements from the Neolithic period. We try to identify the process of craftsmanship and the features of the textile. The wave analysis and technological classification point to only one technique, a two-thread or double weft binding, where the warp is the passive and the weft is the active element of the structure. We identified two variations of two-thread weft binding. On 29 impressions, we were able to identify tight simple as twist twining, where the rows of the webs are tightly packed. On 18 impressions, closed simple S twist twining, where the rows are tightly packed, where the rows are slightly separated. And on two impressions, we were not able to identify the weaving technique. I would like to single out one impression in the middle of the bottom, a tight simple S twist twining was identified. But towards the edge of the fragment, it looks like every thread from the wrap is split into two threads, which increase the density of the structure. Further weaving continued with even thinner weft. The warp is not visible on the impressions. Only information that we have for the warp is from the impressions where damaged parts are visible. We can see that the warp is from two S-twist yarns with diameter of one millimeter. Unlike the warp, the weft is clearly visible. The thickness of the weft is ranging roughly from less than 1 millimeter to 3 millimeters in diameter. On several specimens, an uneven weft can be observed. Although this may be a result of uneven spinning, it also be a result of more or less tension during weaving. On my first attempt, you can see on the right, to reconstruct twining structure, you can see thicker and thinner parts of the weft. This can confirm that the quality and appearance of the fabric depends also on the skills and the performance on the one who produced it. One more reason for uneven weft can be appearance on the fragments. On many fragments, we can see notice protruding and hollow parts, which probably appeared when vessel was made. On the protruding parts, the weft is more visible and have bigger diameter due to stretching in these parts. And on the hollow parts, the weft is not so well visible and has smaller diameter. Fabric counts noted during analysis ranging from 7 to 17 yarn elements per square centimeter. Very fine textile with fabric counts 15 and greater than 15 occur on 10 examples. 25 examples have textile with fabric counts between 10 and 14, and only 3 examples with fabric count less than 10 elements per square centimeters. From this, we can conclude that some of the specimens have densely packed weft with even even tension and uniform angle of the weft, giving the fabric fine, smooth and even structure. Others, on contrary, are uneven with thinner and thicker parts and bumps, giving the rougher appearance of the fabric. Impressions are better visible in the center of the bottom of the vessels, and towards the edge of the bottom they are less or not at all visible. The analyzed textile impressions lack any marks of borders or selvages. The secondary use of worn-out textile was noticed on some impressions during analyze. This is evident by missing elements or distortion on more than the half analyzed impressions. The fabric imprinted on the bottom of the pottery was probably pieces of used clothes or blankets. The pieces of textile imprinted on the clay were probably used either to protect pottery for contamination by dirt while drying after the modeling, or as a support while raising the vessel. Plaited straw mats should have had the same function as the twined fabrics, as suggested by the imprints of mats on the pottery shared from Neolithic settlements. How this textile was manufactured? Although in small numbers, the spindle whorls and long weights can give us a general idea of the process of textile manufacturing at these sites. Documented spindle whorls are from two settlements, Pešterica and Vrbjanska Čuka. The spindle whorls are of discoid shape, made of clay. Most of the perforated spindle whorls were cut off shards, the ends were rounded and a hole was punched in the middle. But also some examples from Vrbjanska Čuka are made of clay which has been molded in the form of disc. The diameter is from 2.5 cm to 8 cm. Their thickness from 0.5 cm to 2 cm and the perforation diameter from 0.2 cm to 1 cm. The weight of the worth is from 6 to 80 grams. Discoid spindle worlds are probably earliest form of spindle worlds and the most often form discovered from the early Neolithic horizon of settlements, and their use continues in the later horizons. Unlike the clay spindle was the earliest discovered stone discoid work is from the Middle Neolithic. In these settlements, biconical works are not detected. Generally, biconical spindle works are rarely found in Neolithic sites in Macedonia. They are discovered in the Middle Neolithic horizons of the settlements, and their use continues in the late Neolithic settlements. Although we don't have direct evidence of using loom, the finds of ceramic and stone loom weights indicate that some type of supported frame, perhaps a vertical warp weighted loom, was used for manufacturing this textile, at least for the densely packed and evenly twined fabrics. The long weights discovered on these sites were made of clay or stone with spherical, discoid, or dumbbell shapes. Two long weights with dumbbell shape were discovered in Vrbjanska Čuka. The weights are made of clay with a cylindrical body 8.5 cm to 11.5 cm long and extended at both ends. The weight is from 240 grams to 300 grams. Weight with dumbbell shapes are discovered in the Neolithic settlements from the early Neolithic. Unlike dumbbell weights from Vrbjanska Čuka, which characterized by larger dimension and weight, on some sites dumbbell shaped weights with smaller dimension, 6.5 cm to 5.5 cm body long, and weight from 40 to 65 grams were discovered. The spherical long weights are represented with only two examples from Vrbjanska Chuka. One loom is made from clay and the other one of stone. The weight made of clay has a diameter of 6.2 centimeters and weighs around 300 grams, and the weight of stone has a diameter of 5.5 centimeters and weighs around 100 grams. In the settlement Chukato-Polchani, discoid loom weights made of stone were discovered. These loom weights are quite large. The diameter is roughly from 6 to 15 centimeters, and the weight is from 200 to 700 grams. On the loom weights has no one of the loom weights has no perforation, but has visible traces of bindings. On the other loom weights, rounded perforation with diameter from 1.5 to 2.5 centimeters were made in the middle. A clay discoid long weight was discovered in Vrbjanska Chuka with a diameter of 6 centimeters, perforation of 1 centimeter, and weight of 96 grams. Oval and conical long weights have not been documented at these settlements, but with these shapes are discovered from the Middle Neolithic phases of the settlements in Macedonia. One exception is the elliptical weight from Govrlevo that has been discovered in the first horizont of life. Given that this is an isolated case, their use in the early Neolithic cannot be confirmed. The surface of the weight is smooth, and at the upper part has a circular perforation. The high ranges, the high of these long weights ranges from 7 centimeters to 10 centimeters, the perforation diameter from 1 centimeter to 2 centimeters, and the weight from 200 to 400 grams. Unfortunately, archaeological textiles in Macedonia were not investigated until now. But even from this basic information, we can suggest that on this territory there was a thriving textile industry from the earliest phases of the Neolithic, revealing a developed stage of the twining textile technology.
Thank you for your attention.